وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد We were in the مظاهر دنو الهمة Ways and forms in which low aspiration manifests. And we've spoken previously about 19 different madahir, different ways. And inshallah ta'ala, today we're going to take the 20th madhar, which is al-ya'su min al-islah. When someone gives up in perfecting or correcting or rectifying themselves or the society they live with. It's when you give up and you believe you cannot rectify the situation of your community or yourself. This is one of the ways of dunu al-himma, low aspiration. And this is something يَقَعُ فِيهِ كَثِيرٌ مِّنَ النَّاسِ many people fall into. For example, they might see الشرور المتراكمة. They may see excessive evil around them. والأمواج المتلاطمة من المصائب والمحن. And ocean of calamities and tribulations. والأهوال والفتن. And trials and problems. ومن الفرقة والتناحر. And division and discord. And disputations. الَّذِي يَسِيرُ فِي صُفُوفِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ That takes place amongst the Muslims. And the person, what does he do? He gives up مِنْ إِصْلَاحِ الْأَحْوَالِ To perfect the situation and to rectify it. They give up on all of that. Once they see the evil widely spread around them and they see the problems in every corner, the disunity, the hate, the prejudice, this discrimination that's present amongst the Muslims, the person gives up in rectifying the problem and going forward in being a means of good or a means of a rectification. فَلَا يَصْمُدُ أَمَامَ هَذَا الْخِطَمِّ الْمَوَّارِ He won't be able to. He doesn't have it in him. Or she doesn't have it in her to stand up in front of this destruction and this tide of problems. And the person chooses not to exert their efforts. And they become يتقاعس ويتكاسل. The person becomes lazy and unable to do it. And all of this is because of اليأس من الإصلاح. The person gives up in rectifying anything. And say the same. وَقُلْ مِثْلَ ذَلِكَ And say the same in what? فِي شَأْنِ كَثِيرٍ مِّنَ النَّاسِ مِمَّنْ يُسْرِفُ عَنْ نَفْسِهِ الْبِالْمَعَاصِ The person, he's falling into sins himself. And he sees how he's addicted to one sin after the other. And he sees himself swimming فِي أَوْدِيَةِ الرَّذِيلَةِ He's swimming in a valley of humiliation and problems. فَتَجِدُهُ And you find that person after looking at them. يَيْأَسُ مِنْ إِصْلَاحِ حَالِهِ He gives up in rectifying his own situation. وَالرُّقِيِّ بِهَا إِلَى الْأَمْثَلِ وَالْأَفْضَلِ And pushing himself to the highest stages and highest levels. He gives up on all of that. Rather, what might happen sometimes is But رُبَّمَا ظَنَّ أَنَّ التَّغْيِيرَ مُسْتَحِيرٌ He might even think that rectification is impossible. It will never happen. No one can do anything about my problems. No one can change society. No one can change the problems that are happening in the world. No one can. بَلْ رُبَّمَا ظَنَّ أَنَّ التَّغْيِيرَ مُسْتَحِيلٌ وَأَنَّ مَا بِهِ مِنْ عَيْبٍ وَنَقْصٍ إِنَّمَا هُوَ. And the person starts to think that the deficiencies and the mistakes and faults and shortcomings that are present in me are all what? إِنَّمَا هُوَ. It is ضَرْبَةُ اللَّازِبْ لَا يَسْتَطِيعُ الْفِكَاكُ عَنْهَا. He believes that it is a reality لا يستطيع الانفكاك عنها, that he can never detach himself from. What I am in right now, the problems I am in, what I have put myself into, is something I can never change, and no one can ever change it. This is what the person starts to think. وَهَذَا كُلُّهُ مَظْهَرٌ مِّن مَظَاهِرِ دُنُوُ الْهِمَّةِ. What we say to that person is that all of that is a form or a way of low aspiration. وَصِغَرِ النَّفْسِ. And that person has a very low mind. That person's nafs is very little. وَالْعَجْزِ عَنْ مُوَاجَهَةِ الْمَتَاعِبِ وَالْمَصَاعِبِ. And what you have is that you are incapable, you are incompetent in facing the painful and hard things in life. وَهَذَا لَا يَلِيقُ. And that is not befitting. بِالْمُسْلِمِ الْحَقِّ. The true Muslim. No. A true Muslim should not think like that. لِأَنَّهُ لَا يَيْأَسُ مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ. Because no one gives up in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَقْنَطُ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ. And no one gives up in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَكُونُ نَظَرُهُ مَقْصُورًا عَلَى الْأُمُورِ الْمَادِيَّةِ. And don't ever allow your observation, what you look at, be based on material things. The Muslim, he never gives up on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows that what Allah has in store is far greater and better than what other people might say. Or what is in front of you? The reality in front of you might be big to you. You might magnify it in your mind. But what you have to remember is, it is not greater than the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't make your observation, don't make what you look at and what you observe be all materialistic things. Wal asbab al-dhahira, and the outer appearance. Bal yakunu mutalaffitan في قلبي في كل وقت إلى مسبب الأسباب إلى الكريم الوهاب متحريا للفرج واثقا بأن الله سيجعل بعد عسر يسرا. Connect your heart every time to the one that made all of this happen. To who? The generous one, the giver. Fill your heart with happiness. Have faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he, Allah azza wa jalla, سَيَجْعَلُ بَعْدَ عُسْرٍ يُسْرًا. After every hardship, Allah is going to make it ease for you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Believe in that with unwavering conviction. وَمِنْ هُنَا. And from this point, inshaAllah ta'ala, and this moment, يَنْبَعِثُ لِلْقِيَامِ بِمَا يَقْدِرُ عَلَيْهِ مِنَ النُّصْحِ وَالْإِرْشَادِ. With that in your mind and that feeling in your heart, stand up wherever you're able to, in advising those who are around you, and calling to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and changing your own affairs and the shortcomings and the faults that you have. وَيَقْنَعُ بِالْيَسِيرِ. Be content with the little. إِذَا لَمْ يُمْكِنْ. If it's not possible. What is not possible? الْكَثِيرَ. The many. وَبِزَوَالِ بَعْضِ الشَّرِّ وَتَخْفِيفِ إِذَا تَعَذَّرَ غَيْرُ ذَلِكَ. And also, try to reduce the evil around you, even if you're not able to remove it in its totality. At least you've stopped one evil. And if everyone thinks like that, then the evil will be stopped. Some people, they think, either I have to rectify this situation in its totality, or I'm not going to do anything. No, you might be able to rectify something of this problem, some issues of it, and not in its totality. Don't worry. Al-umuru biyadillah. All Allah tabarak wa ta'ala controls things. All you are is a weak slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do the best that you can. ثُمَّ إِنَّهُ لَا يَنْبَغِي لِلْمُسْلِمِ. It's not something that should occur from a Muslim. أَنْ يَرْضَى لِنَفْسِهِ بِالدُّونَ. That he is pleased with the bare minimum. وَأَنْ يَتْرُكَ رِيَاضَةَ نَفْسِهِ زَعْمًا مِّنْهُ. And that he leaves off training himself and nurturing and cultivating himself upon that which is good. He leaves it off with the claim that أَنَّ تَبَدُّلَ الْحَالِ مِنَ الْمُحَالِ. Changing is from the impossible. The person says, I'm not going to work on myself. I'm not going to put the effort in. Because wallahi, changing is not something that's going to happen for me. My life is the way it is. I can't change it. وَأَلَّيْسَ فِي الْإِمْكَانِ أَبْدَعُ مِمَّا كَانِ. I say, this is the reality. Allah created me like this. I can't change this. بَلْ يَنْبَغِي لَهُ أَنْ يَأْخُذَ بِالْأَسْبَابِ. What is needed from each and every one of us, that we take the means. وَيَسْعَى لِتَكْمِيلِ نَفْسِهِ. And that you work every day to complete yourself. You know when you came into this world that you were not complete. You were deficient. And every day you're working towards perfecting your situation. وَتَلَافِي عُيُوبِهِ. And every day you're trying to what? Get rid of and eliminate and eradicate those mistakes and shortcomings that are present in you. How many people do we know today, brothers and sisters, that we meet, that we understand their lives has changed for the better when they put that mindset in? فَكَمْ مِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ تَبَدَّلَتْ حَالُهُ وَسَمَتْ نَفْسُهُ وَعَلَتْ هِمَتُهُ. How many people do we know who changed their situation, they rectified their lives for the better? وَسَمَتْ نَفْسُهُ. And their nafs just went up, shot up to the sky. And they came with true high aspiration. وَقَلَّتْ عُيُوبُهُ. And his mistakes became so little. Why? How did that all happen? بِسَبَبِ دَرَبَتِهِ. It all changed because that person trained themselves. وَمُمَارَسَتِهِ وَسَعِيهِ وَمُجَاهَدَتِهِ لِنَفْسِهِ. And that person exerted effort and hard work. They reached the point that they reached. How many people do you know that's happened for? Let me tell you or read on you a statement said by the great Imam. Al-Imam Abu Muhammad ibn Hazm rahimahullah. Ibn Hazm, he talks about an tajribatihi ma'a nafsihi. He talks about his tajriba, his experience with how he trained his nafs. Every single one of us, I myself included, we have things that are in our lives that we need to change and rectify. Every day, what we do is we have a highlighter, which correcting this and this one and this one and this one. Every day, there's things that we're working on. And there's things that we have that are good that we're just nurturing. We're nurturing those things. We're making it better. And there's other things that are deficiencies in us that we're trying to, inshallah ta'ala, correct and perfect them and learn how to make it better. Ibn Hazm is mentioning the same about himself. And this is a human, this is present in everybody. Ibn Hazm is a great scholar. He's talking about how he worked on himself. He said, كانت فيي عيوب. Ibn Hazm said, I had in myself many mistakes, many shortcomings, faults, errors. فَلَمْ أَزَلْ بِالرِّيَاضَةِ. He said, I went out and I trained myself. I worked on, nurtured myself. He said that. And he mentions how he did this. He said, وَطْلَاعِي عَلَى مَا قَالَتِ الْأَنْبِيَاءُ صَلَوَاتُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِمْ. He said, I did اطلاع and read over what the prophets, may Allah be pleased upon them, said. وَالْأَفَاضِلِ مِنَ الْحُكَمَى. And he said, I also read what the virtuous, wise people said. الْمُتَأَخِرِينَ, the latecomers. وَالْمُتَقَدِّمِينَ, the early ones. And I went over what the prophets said. Not just Muhammad, but all the prophets, what they said before. I looked at the virtuous people, the wise people, whether they be in the early times, the Sahabas and the Tabi'in and the Tabi'u Tabi'in, and those who came after them. I looked at what they said, fil akhlaqi, in manners, wa adab in nafsi, and the akhlaq, what they said about it, etiquettes and manners. I looked at all of that. He said, u'ani mudawataha. And he said, I struggled in curing those faults and errors that were with me. Hatta a'ana Allahu azza wa jalla ala akthari dhalika bi tawfiqihi wa mannihi. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helped me and aided me, that I was able to overcome many of those mistakes and shortcomings that were present in me. Allah helped me subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now listen to this. Ibn Hazm is saying, I saw in myself faults at the beginning. Kanat li uyub, I had mistakes, not one. He said, kanat li uyub, I had many mistakes and shortcomings and errors. So first of all, what he did was he recognized that there are faults and mistakes present in him, rahimahullah ta'ala. And then he went out on the conquest of finding out the cures for that illnesses or those mistakes that he has. So he said, I read the statements of the prophets. He said, I read the statements of the wise, noble, righteous people, the early ones, and those who came after. I read their statements. And what he did was, he read what they said about manners and etiquettes, what they said about the nafs and the manners of the nafs and how to nurture the nafs and control it, restrain it, resilience, forbearance, patience, endurance, and qualities that self-discipline, all of those words that we all want. U'ani mudawataha. He said, I struggled in finding the cure for it until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helped me. We know we can't do anything without Allah. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is the one that can cure us from all of the problems and the shortcomings and the errors that we have. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what happened? He said, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala helped me. Ala akthari dhalika, the majority of those things. And he helped me bi tawfiqihi wa mannihi. And he helped me that, he helped me with that, with his kind generosity and his favors. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala chose that to do that for me. So that's the ending of the statement of Ibn Hazm rahimahullah ta'ala. You can find it in his kitab Al-Akhlaq wa Siyar, page 33 to page 34. You can find it there inshallah ta'ala. He mentions many points that he worked on and how he did it. So inshallah ta'ala, go to it. The best taba'a for it inshallah ta'ala is the tahqiq of Sheikh Abdul Haq al-Turkmani. He has a tahqiq on the kitab. So I'm going to stop there inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and his messenger are both free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdi. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now. Click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.